Surprise, that sexy single chatting you up might have an ulterior motive. Tinder, for those of you who haven't heard of it, is a mobile dating app that's a little bit like that terrible old website, hotornot.com. You're shown photos of people in your area, you can like or pass, and if you like each other, then you can message. Maybe. It's highly addictive and the worst or the best, depending on your perspective. But as with any popular service, people do sometimes use it to plug their products or websites, or in some cases, low-budget rap albums. Like this guy, for example. Eating, drinking, smoking are prohibited. Or even TV shows. The Mindy Project placed profiles for their characters in Tinder as a tool to promote the show. And it's definitely not unusual to come across a Tinderer who seems maybe a little more forward than average, linking to their Snapchat, Instagram, or other profiles. But over the past couple weeks, users have been reporting a high number of those sexy singles who seem to be really into one thing. Well, two things. Chatting you up and a game called Castle Clash. Castle Clash is a combat strategy game for Android and iOS that looks like, well, pretty much every other combat strategy game. But it apparently has a lot of fans on Tinder who love the game so much that they're willing to give you their phone number if you play with them. Aaliyah, Alicia, or Haley may work it into a casual conversation about how their night is going. But eventually they stop beating around the bush and ask you to click on an affiliate link, tinderverified.com, which at one point redirected to the game's download links. Castle Clash is made by a company called I Got Games, which is also behind numerous other similar mobile, browser, and PC games like Dawn of Darkness, Wings of Destiny, and Poker Deluxe. According to their site, they operate in the US, Singapore, China, and the Philippines, though no one answered the phone at their Fremont location. And you would think that the company would be the obvious beneficiary of the spam, but they tweeted out earlier that they don't know who's responsible for it, and it's not them. And for what it's worth, the support person I talked to through the app claimed to have no knowledge of it either. For their part, Tinder says they're aware of the spam issue and are continually working to resolve it. But even if you don't use Tinder, variations on this sexy spam bot are everywhere online, and they seem to kind of move like a herd from one social networking site to another. Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, etc. So not that you needed a reminder, but don't click on any affiliate links from random girls you don't know. Unless, of course, that random girl is me. And if you've ever talked to a spam bot without realizing it, let me know your story for a future follow-up piece on the weird world of e-whoring. And for that, you can get in touch with me on Twitter, Facebook, Google, or VK, all at Andy Gauss. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.